John Khan. We are about to just do a silent guard, object guard. I'll walk into the middle of the room, put the dog down, put my bag by it, and then we'll have a passerby circling the bag. The dog at that stage is not allowed to do anything. It's a silent guard. We only want the control by when he tries to steal the bag. So, Fus, go forward. And Blacks, bleed. Bleed. So, clear distance, innocent guy, not a problem. Bleed. Walks around. We educate the dog on the flexible zone. These are flexible zones. That's a security dog, and I'm just going to try and change my ticket. I bought the wrong ticket for Cornwall. Okay. Is there a problem?
No.
Okay, this is a working dog. Don't touch the dog. I don't know why you're circling. Is there a problem?
No.
Flags, please. You've been warned. And as you guys will see now, I will walk over here to buy a ticket. Circle. Get forward. I'm going to call him out of that. I'll put him back in the position. I'm going to do that again.
Out! Out!
Fus! Go forward. Fus! Place. Plats. Link. And here. Fus. Plats. Link. Now, young man, what are you doing?
I was just having a look around. Is that not
right? Private property. We're going to search you. I think we've got something
on
you.
There's no
reason for that. I'm going to send the dog to Marky. He'll be barking at you. As long as you cooperate, you haven't got a problem. You listening to me?
Yeah.
For that!
We are very proud of our training process. The hold and bark is a signature behavior, and I think it's a responsible aspect of protection because it offers a safety net. Reasonable force. This is the same dog that you saw just a moment ago attacking the decoy with passion. But yet we're out in the general public area walking the dog like a normal pet. The on-off switch is real.